The witches of Horizon Forest had a problem. It started as a joke. Agatha, the young curse witch who lived just past the crook in the Rising River, had accidentally gone and given her familiar free will. Agatha swore up and down it was just a hex gone wrong, but her next-door neighbor, an old potions witch, swore that Agatha had done it as a laugh. Regardless, Agatha now had a familiar on her hands that could do as it pleased, and that seemed to be the end of the story. Agatha swore the bird was content, save for demanding better food, so it was a shock to all in the forest when one night the damn bird stole ingredients, and while Agatha was asleep granted herself a more practical size, stole one of Agatha's old wands, and disappeared into the night. Agatha was distraught, of course, but in the end she'd brought it on herself and no one paid it much mind. No one paid it much mind, that is, until other familiars started going missing. It was the old potion maker, Julep, who was the first victim. Her owl familiar vanished in the night, leaving only feathers and scratches and the burn marks of a hex on the floor. She was furious, of course, chewing into Agatha for hours before another went missing as well. Cynthia's peacock familiar gone in a flash with only the sound of laughter. One by one, the familiars of the valley vanished, starting with just the birds before surely the mammals, reptiles, and fish were gone too. The witches had met together to decide a plan of attack when suddenly a figure burst into the clearing where the witches were meeting, framed by so many animals they couldn't be counted. The little figure, a crow girl in a makeshift dress and what looked like one of Cynthia's hats, was surely Agatha's old familiar. "The creatures have spoken," she cried. "We want better treatment, better food, no more spells on us, and we want the weekends off." The witches were speechless. It was Julep eventually that spoke up. "We can work with that." Negotiations were made, contracts signed, and given to the crow for safekeeping, and one by one, the familiars returned to their witches. All except for the crow, who, after a talk with Agatha, decided she much preferred to be a witch instead of a familiar. She named herself Hex, built herself a little nook in a tree, and eventually grew her magic. Eventually, Hex became a master of scrying and locating magics. Folks said that she could find anything so long as it was shiny. And Horizon Forest returned to its sleepy spells and curses. And that's our bird witch. She's a little different from what I normally do, but when I got the prompt in my head, I immediately knew that this was what I wanted to do. And she was so fun! If you want to try your own aesthetic generator challenge, the link is in the description below. And y'all already know the like, subscribe drill. I'm gonna spare you the spiel. Have a great day, eat some great food, make some great art. Bye-bye.